Good afternoon and welcome to the fourth annual STEM Signing Day Chicago. It is such a great honor to be a part of this event. There's nothing more rewarding than looking at 100 applications. We had 100 applications from Chicago Public School students going through a rigorous review of those applications and coming down and identifying 50 of the most amazing young people ever, and such a great honor and such a great privilege. And so I am ready to get started. I hope you are ready to get started. And with that, I will say my name is Natasha Smith-Walker. I am the Executive Director of Project Exploration. We do lead the Chicago STEM Pathways Cooperative, and we are honored to be a part of this process. And so with that, I have the pleasure of introducing Mike Castle, my friend, who has done this with me, and we can't wait to do this in person because we have a lot of fun with this. And so Mike Castle is the Senior Director of Boeing's Global Engagement and State and Local Government of Operations for the company's corporate offices in Chicago and the broader region. In this role, he oversees strategies and programs for enterprise-wide Boeing regional corporate giving and employee engagement for Boeing, the central region, and the government relations for Chicago and Illinois. Mr. Castle worked on the Obama and Biden transition team and on President Obama's first presidential campaign. He has a degree from political science from the University of Arizona. He received his Juris Doctorate from DePaul University of College of Law. He is on the board of directors for the Illinois Manufacturers Association and also an advisory council of Becoming a Man. With that, Mike, I am so pleased and proud to introduce you. Take it away.
Thank you, Natasha. Appreciate it. Hi, Mayor Lightfoot. It is great to see you again, and we're honored to have you here today. Just so you know, this is one of the most exciting days of the year for the teams at Boeing and Motorola because we get to celebrate these amazing students in Chicago and their futures. And as you know, these students that you're addressing here today represent the power and creativity of the youth here in the city of Chicago. And to those students, I just want to quickly say congratulations. This is an exciting time for you all in your lives. And we're really proud to support you in your pursuit of a STEM major in college. I want to introduce you to Mayor Lori Lightfoot, the mayor of Chicago, who is here to honor you today as well. Just a quick background on the mayor. I'm sure you're all very well aware of her background, but Mayor Lightfoot has a background as a lawyer, has practiced in both public and private capacities, including as a U.S. attorney. She has also served the city of Chicago in numerous roles prior to becoming mayor, including most recently on the Chicago Police Board. Mayor Lightfoot has been mayor now for 2 years, and has led our city through an extremely challenging time for the world. And I personally want to say thank you to the mayor for your leadership and commitment to keeping us all safe. In those 2 years, the mayor has had many accomplishments, including focusing on ethics and good governance reform and a path to a 15-hour minimum wage. But what I really want to highlight is the mayor's commitment to being a fierce advocate for the students of this city and her commitment to education. And based on that commitment, I think that the mayor is making the city a better place every day. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to you, Mayor Lightfoot. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you so much, Mike, and I really appreciate that very warm introduction. Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you all for being here. Let me also recognize the other leaders that are going to be part of this presentation today. Motorola Solutions Vice President of Safety Reimagined Program, Sharon Wong. You've heard from one person from Boeing, but you're also going to hear from Boeing Company Director of Engineering, People Strategy, Engineering Strategy and Operations, Candace Smith, and Project Exploration and Chicago STEM Pathways Executive Director Natasha Smith-Walker, who just kicked us off. And I also want to congratulate the 50 Chicago and area high school seniors on being honored here today. This award truly is a great honor. We all know that when our young people have what they need to succeed, our entire city succeeds. And when we invest in your future, we invest in a better future for all of us. That's the driving force behind this incredible event, which recognizes young people and upcoming talent in the STEM field. The 50 students were honored today, and we're honoring today, were selected through their participation in STEM-based curriculum high schools and out-of-school time STEM learning programs. Accomplishments that are especially impressive, particularly after the year that we've all experienced. In the face of great uncertainty, each of these brilliant and talented students stayed focused and determined on their academic paths and achieved excellence. And I want to personally congratulate each and every one of them on their hard-earned accomplishments. At a very young age, you will realize your ability to make a difference in this world and be a change maker in the STEM fields. Your drive and dedication are truly admirable. And you should be extremely proud of all you've accomplished already from both inside and outside the classroom. And though we are beginning to step into that light at the end of a long, dark tunnel, the COVID-19 that we've been in for the past year plus, thanks to vaccines and our city safe reopening strategies, we are making progress, but I want to caution, we're not out of the woods yet. Contributions to the STEM field are needed now more than ever. It was a great, diverse group of very talented professionals, pharmacists, scientists, of various backgrounds that really came together, focused on a mission to deliver a life-saving vaccine. And they did it under daunting odds and difficult circumstances. And I hope you take this as just one example of what you can really do and accomplish in the STEM field. The world will open up a lot of possibilities as a result of the work that you are going to be doing and committed to doing with your teachers, professors, and other colleagues in this area. And it will not only allow you to provide success in your own career, but help ensure the future prosperity of our city, our state, and our nation. And some of you come from communities that were hard hit by COVID-19, namely those on our south and west sides. And for all of you, I know this isn't quite how you envision your senior year and transition to college. But despite these unprecedented challenges, what I'm grateful for is that each of you found the resiliency and perseverance to still accomplish your goals. And that perseverance and that testament to hard work and diligence and focus will serve you well as you carry on through your career and into your adulthood. And for that, I and the entire city are really proud of you. And I want to again thank each of every one of you to know that not only are we proud of you, we stand ready to support you as you move on from high school into college or career. We expect you to be the future scientists, technologists, engineers, our mathematicians, but will be the architects of our post-COVID world. And you will make STEM more diverse and inclusive of experiences like yours. And you will enrich your communities and inspire the next generation of students to chase their dream and obtain success, no matter how many challenges stand before them. I also have no doubt that each of you are going to do wonderful work in this next step of your academic journey. Work that will undoubtedly change our city and our entire world for the better. And as your mayor, I stand committed to make sure that you have everything you need to achieve academic success and pursue future opportunities to advance your career. And much of that is possible thanks to partners like Chicago STEM Pathways Cooperative and companies like Motorola and Boeing, who all recognize that when they give back, when they create opportunities for young people like you, they're not only enriching our city, they're helping build the future scientists, engineers, and professionals that will populate their own companies. So I also want to thank them and the rest of our partners for doing the right thing and investing in you and the next generation of bright and talented young minds that will advance the next cures and causes in the STEM world. Congratulations again on this year's STEM signing day honorees, and I wish you every success as you take the next steps on your lifelong journey of learning. And now I'm going to turn it back over to Natasha.
Thank you, Mayor Lightfoot. It's such a great honor to have you join us, and next year we hope to see you in person. So Thank you very much for participating. We're going to keep it moving. I want to make sure that everybody recognizes that this process that young people have to go through is pretty rigorous. And one of the main things that we're looking for is we want to understand what young people have done around STEM engagement in and out of school during their high school and middle school years. And so right now we're going to take a couple minutes to watch a video that answers two key questions that applicants had to respond to. Why STEM and what is your dream job?
I'm interested in STEM because it's a growing field and it's very diverse. It seems like it's going to be a constant in society.
It's the career field that really gives us a chance to dig into our imagination, creativity, and change our society.
I feel like it would give me a better understanding of the world around me because so many things in our environment can be explained with taking the time to learn simple sciences.
It will teach me critical thinking and how to problem solve.
And also come up with new solutions that will help improve not only our small communities, but also what it takes to improve our country as well.
This is the one part of like education where it tries to explain how the world works around us.
I'm making our world like a little cleaner or better. We like the environment. You know, it's stuff that you could always do with biology.
Because I feel like it's a field that not many minorities go into. And I was just completely curious about it.
My dream job would probably be to work at a notable company at Boeing, NASA, or iRobot.
I aspire to be a software engineer.
My dream job is to work for Apple or Microsoft.
I like building circuits, and I also like the like constructural part of engineering. So like those two, one of those two would be like my dream job.
My dream job is to own my own business.
To become a medical researcher, in order to help other people by coming up with treatments and cures for some tragic diseases.
My dream job is to be an ER surgeon.
My dream job is to create medical devices to distribute to low-resource communities. Seeing the huge disparities in access to healthcare both here in Chicago and across the world has really motivated me to use STEM for humanity.
Impressive. I am actually grateful to know that we have young people like these recipients that are going to take over and pursue all these amazing fields around STEM education and thoughtfully thinking about exactly what it is that they want to do. So watch out, world. You guys have an amazing group of young people that are coming through our system and ready to take over. It is my great pleasure now to introduce Sharon Hong. She is the Vice President of Safety Reimagined Program, the service offer management and worldwide educator at Motorola Solutions. Her journey with Motorola Solutions began in 2000 as a systems engineer in California. She then thought out opportunities of increasing responsibility with the products and sales organization, culminating her role as Chief of Staff and Senior Director of Sales Operations. Sharon earned her bachelor's degree in electrical engineering from the University of California, Los Angeles, and her master's in engineering management from the University of Southern California. Sharon, welcome. And
oh, Natasha, thank you so much for that kind introduction. And thank you again, Boeing and Project Exploration, for partnering with us today on the initiative that we're in today, which is the fourth annual Chicago STEM Signing Day. So again, I'm Sharon Hong, and it is an honor for me to be here on behalf of Motorola Solutions and also the Motorola Solutions Foundation. But more importantly, it's an honor for me to be here with you, the next generation of top talent in STEM in our communities. You know, I've been with Motorola Solutions for over 20 years now, and that's not common to be with a technology company for that long. But the reason I've stayed as long as I have is because of the mission that we serve, and that is to provide technology for communications and software to first responders. And, you know, I started out as an intern at Motorola over 20 years ago, and my first job was actually in systems engineering, where I was able to design communication systems for public safety and actually deploy them as well. And, you know, I always say that STEM is such a great place to start in your career. And, you know, from that education or that engineering role that I was in, I was able to branch out over the last 20 years to eight other different jobs
from sales to business operations to other things in leadership, and ultimately leading to the role I'm in today. And so I always say it's just such a great place to start. It opens up so many roads for you when you start with STEM in your career. And, you know, I just love knowing that everything that I've done here at Motorola ultimately goes towards the ultimate mission of saving lives. And that's something that has always been so rewarding to me, is so near and dear to my heart. Now, a lot of you are, all of you are about to graduate high school and move on to college. And just in watching that video, it's so impressive to see the line of all the different colleges that you're all going to. So congratulations on that. And I know when I was in your shoes, you know, I did like hearing about different people in the industry and about the jobs that they had and the careers that they have. But what I really wanted to know was to get some advice and guidance on just the vast future that lay ahead of me. A lot of just unknowns that sometimes felt a little bit intimidating. And so what I'd like to do right now is just impart to you, pass on to you three things that I've learned in the last 20 years or so in my STEM career, things that I wish that people had told me when I was younger. And so number one is grades and scores are important, but so is everything else. So, you know, I grew up in a household where my parents told me, you know, just work hard, get good grades, get into college, get a good job, and you're basically set for life. And what I've learned is that while good grades and hard work will help you get in the door into college and into that first job, it's really the skills that you're not graded on that will help you go far. Skills like accountability, teamwork, being a good communicator, building relationships, understanding the needs of others, and just focusing on people. You know, when you focus on the people who are around you, the people you work with, and understanding what it is they need to be successful, that in turn helps you be successful. And as you meet different people in college, as you get to know other folks, as you move into your career, it's so important to focus on people, because ultimately that's how you build influence and that's how you make big change. Number two is choose the choice that feels bigger than you, to the point that you feel uncomfortable. So over the next several years and throughout your life, you're going to be presented with big opportunities where you might say, I'm not sure if I'm good enough for that or if I could do that. And you may wonder to yourself, should I go for it? And in those times, I encourage you to think and listen to the voice in your head. And if the voice is saying things like, I'm not sure I'm qualified, what if, I really don't know how this is going to turn out. And if you're really honest with yourself in that moment and you admit to yourself that that's your insecurity talking, that's how you know that that's the opportunity that you should go for, because that's the opportunity that will give you the biggest amount of growth. And you will come out on the other end just stronger, better, smarter, and a more experienced person, despite the tumbles and falls that you may have in the journey along. But I think it's just so important to not doubt what you're capable of and to be brave enough to go big. And lastly, I just want to say to just leverage what makes you different to shine bright in your own way. You know, today, in today's world, there's a lot of pressure to maintain a public self, to show our best selves off, but sometimes we may not be showing our most authentic self. And I encourage you to know your strengths and not be afraid to be yourself. You know, as an ethnic woman, leader in technology, a lot of times I'm the only person who looks like me in the room. And in the past, I used to think that maybe conforming with the other people in the room would help me be more accepted. But what I found was that I wasn't being true to myself and I wasn't my best self, because trying to mimic the behaviors of others just wasn't very natural for me. And so what I learned is that when I enter a room, it's not very hard for people to figure out who Sharon Hong is, because I'm different. And I leverage those differences and what makes me different to really stand out quickly, to make an impression, but I do it in my own way. And so I encourage you, as you move forward and you meet new people, you go through new challenges over the next several years and throughout your career, be true to yourself, be yourself, and know that who you are and being true to yourself allows you to shine as brightly as you can. You know, I hope these tidbits of advice will help you as you venture out into the world, you know, because I really, at the end of the day, I want to see you succeed. because we need students like you who are passionate and committed to pursuing STEM degrees to continue to advance science and technology in our world. And that's why the Motorola Solutions Foundation is a staunch supporter of technology and engineering education programs, because we believe it's critically important to support the next generation of inventors and change makers. And that starts with each of you being recognized today. You know, over the last 10 years, our foundation has granted nearly $60 million to STEM programs across the globe. And today, Motorola Solutions and our foundation are proud to provide to you each a $1,000 scholarship to pursue your future in STEM. And I want to congratulate you on this wonderful achievement. So just know we are behind you every step of the way. I'm behind you every step of the way. And you should all be proud of your achievements up until this point. And I expect that you will continue to achieve as you move forward into college and beyond. I look forward to seeing you as an intern either here at Motorola Solutions in the upcoming years or at another innovative company. And I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Sharon, thank you. I heard so many amazing messages. Authenticity. I love that. Young people, be who you are, strive to be the best that you can be. I also heard that sometimes it's really important to find someone in your pathway that can help be a mentor to you, a sounding board. And what's really, really exciting is that you all in this particular STEM signing cohort will be the first cohort that actually gets involved in our STEM mentorship program. We're going to drop the link in the chat, but please make sure, take the time, find a mentor, find someone that you can connect with that perhaps is also walked the same path that you've walked and is willing to give you those thoughtful pieces of advice as you go through that process. I really love that. I love that point around authenticity. The other thing that I want to share is that through this process, there are opportunities for internships. We're going to make sure to keep connected. And so want to make sure that you get us your emails, that we're staying connected with you, because oftentimes there's scholarships that come out, there's internships, there's jobs. It's really my pleasure to actually talk about this one instance. I was actually on LinkedIn doing a little bit of scrolling and seeing who was on there. And I ran upon a young person on there when I saw that what they had put onto their resume portfolio, I thought, wow, this is a really interesting candidate. And I think we should contact them because we had a job open for them. And much to my surprise, when this young person submitted their resume, the first thing that I saw on her resume was she was a STEM Signing Day alumni. At that moment, I sent that resume to my deputy director and said, let's hire this young lady because no matter what is going on, they deserve a job with us. And so it's my great pleasure to introduce an alumni video that Paola Ramirez has created for us. And it's so amazing also to share that she will be joining us this summer as a STEAM ambassador and working with our program. So let's see the video.
Hello, Signing Day signees. My name is Paola Ramirez, and I was also a signee in 2018 when I graduated from Chicago Academy High School. I am currently a junior at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, studying natural resources and environmental science with a minor in geology. Coming into college, I was super excited and ready to learn about things that I was actually passionate about. And something that came as a surprise to me was that it wasn't as easy as things used to be for me in high school. I definitely struggled and had a hard time, but something that I always did was try again. I always, even when I failed, I tried again and I eventually succeeded. So my biggest advice to you guys is to try again, ask for help. There are always people willing to help you and wanting to see you succeed. One of the things I realized as a signee in 2018 was that the work that I was doing outside of school or the interests I had in STEM were important and other people thought were important too. And people thought that should be celebrated. And I hope that you guys see that as well and realize that you do deserve to be celebrated. So congratulations, class of 2021, and I wish you all the best.
Okay, it is my great pleasure now to introduce Candace Smith from the Boeing Company. Candace is currently responsible for the engineering people strategy aimed at ensuring a world-class experience at the global technical teams advance through their entire career lifecycle. She was previously Director of Enterprise Engineering, responsible for strategies to advance functional excellence around people, processes, and tools around across the engineering and value stream. Candace also served in the Illinois Army National Guard Military Police Battalion and later with a signal company while earning her Bachelor's of Science degree in Electrical Engineering from Southern Illinois University Carbondale. She also earned a Master's in Systems Engineering from the Missouri University of Science and Technology and achieved a Professional Project Management Certificate. She also is a member of Delta Sigma Theta sorority and proudly serves as board chair of Project Sincere, a great youth STEM engagement program and an active member of Midtown Educational Foundation Advisory Council. Candace, welcome, and we're looking forward to hearing your amazing words.
Natasha, thank you so much for that gracious introduction. I hear those words and I still can't believe that's been my journey, and it's all because of my interest in STEM. I can barely contain my excitement for our 2021 STEM Signing Day. I want to say thank you to the leaders in the city of Chicago, my colleagues at Boeing, Motorola Solutions, and each and every partner, Natasha, that made this moment possible for all of us to show up and show out in support and celebration of our STEM scholars. To all 50 STEM Signing Day scholars, congratulations. You are off to a tremendous start. And if that video is any indication, nothing can stand in your way, and we're all standing with you. You know, Boeing created STEM Signing Day and to honor students like all of you for your accomplishments, right? And your commitment to continued excellence in science, technology, engineering, and math. Just to give you an idea of how big the celebration has gotten, this year alone, Boeing honored almost 600 students across 15 states. And so today, you are part of an exceptional group representing the city of Chicago, my hometown. I could not be prouder. You should also be proud of yourselves for what you've accomplished and what you will accomplish through the power of STEM. Now, we were talking about alumni. You are all part of nearly 2,000 STEM alumni and MVPs who made a commitment at STEM Signing Day event since its inception in 2017. In fact, many of our first class of scholars are preparing to graduate college and start their careers or businesses full-time this year. Well, let me tell you, it really does not start there. My mentee was a 2019 STEM Signing Day scholar, Stephen Wilson. He went on to study mechanical engineering at The Ohio State. This summer, he'll join Boeing as an engineering intern. Now, it's not because I gave him a vote of confidence and said, hey, take this resume, he's a good student, hire him. It's because he was ready. He did it for himself. He stayed committed to personal excellence and sharpening his STEM skills at school. Like, he really owned it. It was a joy to watch. He sought help when things got really tough. And y'all know it got tough this last year. And despite incredible obstacles, he's learning that STEM skills can help him solve problems, get on a clear path toward independence, go where the money resides, and solidify his place in helping make this world a better place. I'm just so blown away by his talent and your caliber of creativity and innovative thinking. Your STEM knowledge coupled with your ability to boldly create and innovate, you know, as I saw for some of those videos in the fields that you guys want to go into, those really comprise the core principles that we use every day here at Boeing to design, build, test, launch, and maintain our products. And these are some diverse products. I mean, we operate in cyberspace, on land, in air, sea, and even beyond the clouds into space. We rely on talented people with a strong STEM skill set and yet a mindset of it's possible. That mindset helps to ensure that Boeing continues to lead the way in the aerospace industry. And at Boeing, we want to ensure that all of you have a chance to develop your skills, fulfill your dreams, and help build the future. Now, in order to do that, I am excited to reiterate that a mentorship program was launched for all 2021 STEM Signing Day honorees and previous alumni. All of you have the opportunity to be matched with a Boeing and Motorola Solution teammate who works in a field that you are interested in studying or learning more about. Take full advantage of that. You will be able to network, ask questions about educational pathways, learn more about what it's like to work in a STEM career at a particular company like Boeing and Motorola Solutions, and hopefully sharpen your focus to achieve your dreams and get beyond anything that's standing in your way. Again, take full advantage of those mentoring relationships. We know what it's like to dream. Let us help make your dreams reality. Let us help put you in positions to solve problems. Let us help you give back to your community. I know, you know, that I would not be as fulfilled in my life if I didn't have mentors who encouraged me to tackle challenges that scared me, you know, just scared me, and to also step into spaces where I was dared not to, right? And I'm going to say that again. Without a mentor, I don't know that I would have had the confidence to step into spaces that dared me not to. And so like Sharon said earlier, be true to yourself. It is the most consistent thing that's within your control. And I know I'd appreciate the privilege of having you fully represent yourself and be who you are in any place that we work in, you know, innovate together. The pursuit of STEM career can be hard. You know, I will tell you that firsthand because it was hard for a year for me, but my cheer posse wouldn't let me quit. So I want to say to the parents, the guardians, the teachers, career counselors, mentors, friends, all everybody who continue to support these students, I extend my sincerest gratitude. I thank you for your belief in these students, for your tireless encouragement, and most importantly, I thank you for your love because it takes that. So scholars, again, congratulations. You have worked so hard to get to this point. We look forward to supporting you on your continued journey. I can't wait to see where your journey will lead you. And who knows, maybe one day, just maybe, that journey will lead you to start a career at Boeing, and I will be waiting to welcome you. Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Candace, thank you. And I love that, a cheer posse. That is amazing. For all our STEM Signing Day recipients right now, Candace Smith, make sure that you throw your email in there. Tell her you want her to be your mentor. Sounds like she does a great job with mentoring students. I'm putting that plug out there, Candace, because congratulations for getting a Boeing intern into your fold. Congratulations. And I love this whole notion of a cheering posse. With that, I want to also say that we have the distinct pleasure of having Parker Community Academy Middle School Classroom in our audience. They are part of the cheer posse, but more importantly, they are young people who are interested in STEM, and you high school students are starting to become their role models. So step up, realize that you have such an incredible role to your peers under, you know, your younger peers. We actually, this is a new thing for us. They reached out, they said, hey, we would love our middle school students to start to aspire and see what it means to be a STEM Signing Day recipient. So for all of our Parker Community Academy students, welcome. The fun is yet to come. With that, I want to just say that we're going to have one more video. Who is your STEM role model? What excites you about your future? And so for our Parker students, check this out, because our young people are telling you who their role models are. And I can't wait to see who your role models are going to be, Parker Community Academy students. So we'll go ahead and play that video.
My role model within the STEM field is Neil deGrasse Tyson. I really think he was just a kid that just loved science so much and had a very big personality, and combined those two, his love for art and expression and science, and combined those two and made a whole career out of it.
My parents are my role models because they never had an education. They both are immigrants from Mexico, so they never had like the type of opportunities that me as like someone who was born here.
My role models are both of my parents. They work hard day to day to provide the best opportunities for me to achieve what I want to do in education.
My grandpa and Elon Musk. I say my grandpa because he taught me everything I know about engineering. And I say Elon Musk because he is very innovative and willing to take risks.
Marie Skłodowska-Curie. As a first-generation Polish-American, she was truly my first instance of representation in STEM, and it was truly not only an inspiration, but a motivation.
What excites me most about my future is the endless possibilities it holds, that I have the power and opportunity to mold it into something that I want to.
Being able to become a role model for the kids in my family, and the people in my community.
Being able to expand my knowledge and using it to help everyone around me.
I'll be having a career that like I'll be enjoying for myself, and a career that like there's endless possibilities.
Meeting new people and becoming a role model to my younger siblings and my community.
Learning about new things and overcoming obstacles.
To see the change and the impact I had on my community and what happened to me and what I did with my life.
Especially excited to uplift the Black community and help my community start on its healing journey, because we've been through so much. And you know, it's just time to heal and uplift ourselves, because I feel like when you actually take the time to heal, you can do some creative and powerful things within yourself.
Thank you. It is my great pleasure now to actually start the official ceremony recognizing our STEM Signing Day honorees. What will happen now is you will see a slide. Ahmed, you get to actually take advantage of this because you're getting to see your slide right now. Take a screenshot of it, have some fun with it. To our parents, take a picture, do what you need to do, because this is your opportunity to really celebrate your young person. So with that, we're gonna get started. So our first STEM Signing Day recipient is Ahmad Cooper, who will graduate from Corliss Early College STEM High School and will pursue a degree in psychology, medical science from Millbury College. Our next, Arika Carr, who will graduate from Chicago Vocational Career Academy and will pursue a degree in computer science from Southern Illinois at University of Edwardsville. Our next candidate, Amarian Lee, will graduate from Whitney Young Magnet High School and will pursue a degree in biochemistry and psychology from Xavier University of Illinois. Amari Middleton will graduate from Whitney Young Magnet High School and will pursue a degree in biology from Case Western Reserve University. Amir Henderson will graduate from Lindblom Math and Science Academy and will pursue a degree in neuroscience from the University of Michigan. Amira Ibrahim will graduate from Lindblom Math and Science Academy and will pursue a degree in computer science from Northeastern University. Anastasia Wasowski will graduate from Northside College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in biomedical engineering from the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Andrea Luna will graduate from Solario Academy High School and will pursue a degree in computer science and psychology from Oberlin College. Angela Blanco will graduate from Back of the Yards College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in mechanical engineering from the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. Antoinette Brown will graduate from Corliss Early STEM High School and will pursue a degree in animal behavior science from Olive Harvey College. Avery Sims will graduate from George Westinghouse College Prep and will pursue a degree in environmental science from Columbia University. Bailey Nikoloff will graduate from Northside College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in biomedical engineering from the University of Rochester. Bianca Yepa will graduate from the Chicago High School for Agricultural Sciences and will pursue a degree in animal science from the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. Brittany Kelly will graduate from Hyde Park Academy High School and will pursue a degree in nursing from Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University. Brian Gonzalez Del Galilo will graduate from John Hancock College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in biochemistry from Dominican University. Camila Morales will graduate from the Back of the Yard College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in zoology from Ohio Wesleyan University. Darnell Shields will graduate from Charles Allen Prosser Career Academy High School and will pursue a degree in civil engineering from North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University. Destiny Rodriguez de Anava will graduate from Solario Academy High School and will pursue a degree in mathematics from Connecticut College. Elisa Smith will graduate from Sarah E. Good STEM Academy and will pursue a degree in chemical engineering from the University of Missouri. Francisco Cruz Cruz will graduate from Thomas Kelly College Preparatory and will pursue a degree in chemical engineering from the University of Illinois at Chicago. Giselle Salgado will graduate from Lindblom Math and Science Academy and will pursue a degree in computer science from the Illinois Institute of Technology. Grace Juan Cole will graduate from Lindblom Math and Science Academy and will pursue a degree in biology from Brown University. Guadalupe Montero will graduate from Solario High School and will pursue a degree in natural resources and environmental science from the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. Isabella Iniguez will graduate from Solario Academy High School and will pursue a degree in computer science from Harvey Mudd College. Jada Harmon will graduate from Chicago Tech Academy and will pursue a degree in computer science from DePaul University. Jalen Taylor will graduate from Perspective Math and Science Academy and will pursue a degree in computer and electrical engineering from the University of Massachusetts Boston.
Good grammar and
Janaya Flowers will graduate from Michelle Clark Academic Prep Magnet High School and will pursue a degree in biology from Clark Atlanta University.
You need to think.
Jalen Lockhart will graduate from Whitney Young Magnet High School and will pursue a degree in neuroscience from Middlebury College. Jennifer Martinez Colin will graduate from the Back of the Yards College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in biochemistry from the Illinois Institute of Technology. Jennifer Loa will graduate from Farragut Career Academy and will pursue a degree in computer science from the Illinois Institute of Technology. Jose Garcia will graduate from Corliss Early College STEM High School and will pursue a degree in biology from the Illinois Institute of Technology. Josiah Smith will graduate from Sarah E. Good STEM Academy and will pursue a degree in mechanical engineering from Tennessee State University. Kaylee Maxey will graduate from Chicago High School for Agricultural Sciences and will pursue a degree in industrial engineering from Purdue University. Caitlin Schumacher will graduate from Walter Payton College Preparatory High School and will pursue a degree in biomedical engineering from Vanderbilt University. Kiera Gurley will graduate from James E. H. Bowen High School and will pursue a degree in science from Southern Illinois University, Carbondale. Kirana Robinson will graduate from Corliss Early College STEM High School and will pursue a degree in biology from Georgia State University. Lamore Benjamin will graduate from the Chicago Vocational Career Academy High School and will pursue a degree in graphic design from Iowa State University of Science and Technology. Maya Penn will graduate from Henry Diet High School for the Arts and will pursue a degree in health science from Spelman College. Maddie Bravo will graduate from Eric Solario Academy and will pursue a degree in chemistry from the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. Marisol Jimenez will graduate from Lindblom Math and Science Academy and will pursue a degree in engineering from Boston University. Mina Chichek-Alu will graduate from Walter Payton High School, Preparatory High School, and will pursue a degree in cognitive science and computer science from the University of California, San Diego. Mayla Marshall will graduate from Whitney Young Magnet High School and will pursue a degree in chemical engineering from Xavier University of Louisiana. Oriana Middleton will graduate from Michelle Clark Magnet High School and will pursue a degree in computer science from Northern Illinois University. Paige Washington will graduate from Gwendolyn Brooks College Preparatory Academy and will pursue a degree in astrophysics, physics, and physics from the University of Minnesota. Sabine Ramirez will graduate from Epic Academy Charter High School and will pursue a degree in mechanical engineering from Purdue University. Sarah Roan will graduate from Walter Payton High School, College Preparatory High School, and will pursue a degree in biology from the University of California, Los Angeles. Thomas Biddings Jr. will graduate from Verizon Science Academy and will pursue a degree in electrical engineering from Morehouse College. Xavier Martinez will graduate from Sarah E. Good STEM Academy and will pursue a degree in pharmaceutical science from Loyola University. Isama Salazar will graduate from William Jones College Preparatory and will pursue a degree in agricultural and environmental science from the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. Zadia Hurdle will graduate from Sarah E. Good STEM Academy and will pursue a degree in mathematics from Bradley University. It is such a great honor to congratulate every one of you in your accomplishment of becoming a STEM Signing Day awardee. Congratulations and best of luck. I do want to share a couple thoughts as you think about this. You are now part of the STEM Signing Day community. You will be connected with mentors, other alumni, and other young people who are pursuing STEM in their futures. Welcome it. Connect with them. Be a part of that community. Your honor, this honor came to you because you had aspired to be something. You had aspirations and you had goals. Pursue those. Between Sharon and Candace and Mayor Lightfoot and Mike Castle, all of those folks have given you amazing thoughts, amazing words of encouragement in this pursuit. Please take the honor of also listening to a now fellow STEM Signing Day alumni, Paola Ramirez, who went to the University of Illinois at Champaign-Urbana and is studying natural resources and environmental sciences. She worked at Lincoln Park Zoo. She worked for the Chicago Botanical Garden. These are all opportunities that came to her because she stayed connected. Stay connected with us. Allow us to be there for you. Please, I'm going to ask that we get the mentor link to be dropped in there. Sign up. Let us help you find a mentor. You are our trailblazers. You are the young people who are our next generation. We are excited. We are honored to be here to congratulate you. And with that, we officially have now completed STEM Signing Day 2021. Congratulations to all of our honorees. Thank you.